Good afternoon. In his multiple appearances for us, Pietro da Maria has always given distinguished interpretations of the works he offers. His is genuine rapport, both with the literature and with our audiences, as those of you who have never heard him before are about to find out for yourselves. The point of departure for this recital is Frédéric Chopin, more beloved by far than any other Romantic era composer, I think it's safe to say. A man with more than 90% of his total works in the active repertoire. You can't say that about Schubert, Schumann, Liszt, or even Rachmaninoff. Let me show you what two women have said about Chopin. First, the wordsmith Doris Mortman in her novel Wild Rose. Haydn taught us capriciousness. Beethoven introduced us to anger. Rachmaninoff to melancholy. Wagner was demonic. Bach, pious. Schumann was mad. And because his genius was able to record his fight for sanity, we heard what isolation and the edge of lunacy sounded like. Liszt was lusty and vigorous and insisted that we confront his sexuality as well as our own. I'm not sure about that. Chopin was a poet. And without him, we never would have understood what night was, what perfume was, what romance was in music. That last, I think, is a very interesting description. But I want to show you one by a woman who lived with Chopin for 7 years, another writer, the Baroness Aurore Dudevant, who was known by her pen name, George Sand. In her autobiography, we find, his genius was filled with the mysterious sounds of nature, but transformed into sublime equivalence in musical thought, and not through slavish imitation of actual external sounds. The gift of Chopin is the expression of the deepest and fullest feelings of emotions that have ever existed. He made a single instrument speak the language of infinity. His were poems in tones of boundless exaltation, dramas of unequaled power. Now, if you think only women had exceptional points to make about the Polish-born composer, here are the words of enormous respect by the arch-romantic poet Heinrich Heine. Chopin's fame is aristocratic. It is perfumed with the approval of good society. It is as distinguished as his person. He is neither Pole, Frenchman, nor German. He betrays a far higher origin and seems to have come from the land of Mozart, Raphael, and Goethe. With these effusive words in mind, listen to the works ahead and see what you might say to your friends at intermission about the man and the music you've just heard. To conclude his recital's opening half, Mr. De Maria has chosen a fascinating piece of bravura display, the second of four works titled Scherzo. Schumann, on the left, expressed concern that his friend Chopin had used the old term for a kind of musical joke, scherzo, to name a composition that Schumann said was so overflowing with tenderness, boldness, love, and contempt. Certainly, like the other scherzi, this is an audacious transformation of an 18th century idea used literally hundreds of times by Haydn and Mozart. Chopin kept the form, scherzo, trio section and lyrical contrast, and scherzo again. But he changed the nature of its expression to one of drama. Chopin's leap of imagination influenced subsequent scherzi composed by Brahms, Dukas, and Stravinsky.